The NFL regular season is finally here. It's week one, and we've got the Pittsburgh Steelers taking on the Buffalo Bills. Use the promo code KICK to save yourself 20% off of the entire site. I'm Allie Burns from Picks and Parlays. With me today, I've got Ross Benjamin, the man, the myth, the capper. What's happening, Ross?
The man, the myth, the legend went out the window. It's the capper now. Hey, boy, oh boy. You guys are tough on me, but thank you for the kind words, Ellie.
I like to mix it up a little bit. You know, we mix it up a little bit. So, yeah, Steelers are at the Bills. Bills are the favorite, -6.5. You're on the right side of 7 for that one. We got a total of 48.5. What's your play going to be on this one, Ross?
Well, I'm going to look at the total here in this game. I'm going to stay away from the side. These teams have met each of the past two seasons, and both games went under the total. And also, this is a Pittsburgh team. Write this down, Ellie, because I want the, in a matter of fact, I want the listeners and viewers to write this down as well and check it for themselves. The Pittsburgh Steelers have played 45-14 to the under in their last 59 road games. 45-14 to the under in their last 59 road games. You heard it right. That's over 76% of the time. So you can't ignore that. Buffalo's gone 7-3 to the under in their last 10 non-division home games. And the Bills, since 2019, have played NFC North teams 6 times, including twice against Pittsburgh, as I alluded to. And all 6 of those games went under the total. This total opened at 51. It's down to 48.5. This despite the fact the 52% of tickets and 56% of money have gone to the over. So we're seeing a little bit of reverse line movement. And this just in, folks, the public doesn't line up early to bet games under. Okay? That's sharp money. I'm going under the total of 48.5 in this one, Ellie.
67%. Okay. Written down. Gotcha, Ross. Thank
76%. 76%.
76, he says.
It's all even right. Better, yes.
45-14 to the under, hot dog. That is quite a trend right there. So I don't know why we wouldn't follow it. And Ross, by the way, there's a lot of people that say you can't make money on preseason football, but I know for a fact that you're one of those people who did. How'd you do in the NFL preseason this year?
Well, I started off 2-4, Ellie. Then I hit 8 straight in a row, lost my last 2, finished 10-6, but an 8-2 run to finish the NFL preseason. Thank you for asking. And also, folks, a lot of people say, well, it's really tough, Ross, in September in the NFL. You know, we don't have a read on anything. Well, I'm here to tell you. I can't mention a website. If you need documentation, get a hold of Craig. I can provide it for him. Since 2010, I'm 99-48 against the spread in the month of September. So if you want to get off to a good start, picksandparlays.net, Ross Benjamin, NFL, let's do it.
And you can find all of Ross's current stats. He just joined us back in April, but you can find all of his current stats on the picksandparlays.net leaderboards. Until you get over to the site, we're taking it under in the Steelers at the